The infamous Ender 3 stock motherboard is quite crappy. It uses TrimPod to control the motor current and has noisy A4988 taper drivers. The fact that makes even worse is A4988 driver dies sometimes, and you cannot replace them. My Ender 3 motherboard died too. So I decided to replace the motherboard with BigTreeTech SKR Mini V3. SKR Mini Series is drop-in replacement motherboard for Ender 3 and its variant. It has more powerful microcontroller and has many features like touchscreen port, dual Z motor port, UPS port, new pixel port, and more. So I purchased it without hesitation. The motherboard has sealed with ESD protection bag. This is the first look of the board. All exposed pads are gold plated. They included 5 jumpers for sensorless homing, which I will never use. Core microcontroller is STM32G0. I moved on to board replacement. At first, I connected cables one by one to avoid confusion, but at the end, I just followed the pinout diagram. You can follow the wiring guide in the description. Only notable thing is the stock board uses screw terminal for heatsink fan connection, but SKR Mini uses the connector. So I soldered female headers to fan wire to connect them to SKR Mini. This is how it looks when the wiring is done. It is kinda messy, but will do the job. Now hardware part is done. Next up is configuring firmware. First, I downloaded latest Marlin firmware source. You can choose either stable source or nightly source. Then I downloaded configuration example for Ender 3 SKR Mini V3. To edit the config for my favor, I launched Visual Studio Code and uncommented BLTouch related entries. I will post a link to the guide for configuring Marlin in the description. Finally, I proceed to build with AutoBuild Marlin plugin. To flash the firmware, I copied the firmware file to TF card and inserted to printer. and powered the machine up. And then it's done. Now I can easily adjust motor current settings and print quietly.